Today on X-Play! You've waited 6 years for this moment, and now it's finally here! Brace yourself for our review of Half-Life 2! Plus superheroes, Vietnam, and Robotech. But seriously, Half-Life 2! It's game time! Please welcome two people writing out their contracts, Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Me writing.
Oh, I see. Normally I'd say hello and welcome to X-Play, but we finally have Half-Life 2, so who cares about being formal?
This is the sequel to one of the best and biggest PC games ever made, 1998's Half-Life.
And we've been waiting for Half-Life 2 for years.
It was supposed to come out in September of 2003.
And then there were leaks, there was stolen code, there was hacking.
And at times we wondered if Half-Life 2 would ever be released and if it would be completely dated by the time it did.
Well, wonder no more, it's here. And we have our review later in the show.
But that's not all by a long shot.
We also have Robotech.
A game where you get to play as an evil super genius.
And another darn Vietnam game.
This is like the fifth one we've reviewed in this 1 month.
I know. But we begin by ramping up your excitement for our Half-Life 2 review by spoiling the ending from the first game. And if you haven't beaten it by now, well, you've had 6 years to do it. There's no excuse.
This automated train is provided for the security and convenience of the Black Mesa Research Facility personnel.
And so it begins in Half-Life. You're a scientist, Gordon Freeman. It's all peaches and cream at the creepy government facility where you work. Until, of course, something goes terribly wrong and a portal is opened to alien worlds. Bummer, I know. Yay, those don't look like Bob's cats. Sick, dude. You're eating my friend. Oh, hi, Bob. Is this because I killed your cats? Sorry, dude. Your cats were beat. Great. Now the government wants me dead as part of a gruesome cover-up to their covert alien activities.
I suspect there is an immense portal over there, created by the intense concentration of a single powerful being.
Oh, great. I see where this is going. Now I have to go and close down the portal invasion by going to the very world that spawned it. Ooh, this place looks scary. And this guy, with the really big head. I bet he has enough concentration to open portals. I would too if my head were that big. So, you shoot all the crystals, including the one inside his head, and let's watch.
Gordon Freeman in the flesh. Or rather, in the hazard suit, I took the liberty of relieving you of your weapons. Most of them were government property. As for the suit, I think you've earned it. The border world, Zen, is in our control for the time being, thanks to you. Quite a nasty piece of work you managed over there. I am impressed. That's why I'm here, Mr. Freeman. I have recommended your services to my employers. And they have authorized me to offer you a job. They agree with me that you have limitless potential. You've proved yourself a decisive man, so I don't expect you'll have any trouble deciding what to do. If you're interested, just step into the portal, and I will take that as a yes. Otherwise, well, I can offer you a battle you have no chance of winning. Rather an anticlimax after what you've just survived. Time to choose. Well, it looks like we won't be working together. No regrets, Mr. Freeman.
Okay, so he wasn't kidding when he said you'd die. Well, let's try this again, then. I'd love to join a malevolent and sinister government agency. The portal it is.
Wisely done, Mr. Freeman. I will see you up ahead.
Well, it is sort of anticlimactic, isn't it?
That spoiler reminds me of a haiku I wrote about the original Half-Life. Mm. Scientists are good. Things from outer space are bad. So is the ending.
Yeah, we're not big fans of the end of the first Half-Life. Now, how do we like the end of the second one? Find out when we review Half-Life 2 later in the show.
But first, a moment of bliss for all the Robotech nerds out there.
People love the Robotech anime series, but so far there hasn't been a good game made out of it. Will Robotech Invasion change that?
Find out in our review.
I like games with generic gameplay.
Well, I like games with 80s cartoons.
No way, generic gameplay.
Dude, 80s cartoons.
Generic gameplay.
80s cartoons.
Generic gameplay.
80s cartoons.
Hey, slow down, interns. Now there's a game that combines workmanlike action and cliched animation.
There is?
That's right, peons. I give you Robotech Invasion.
Robotech Invasion? Wow!
That's right. Hot on the heels of the easily forgotten Robotech battle cry comes the latest in the ongoing Robotech journey. But this time, Robotech has an edge. And we don't mean the bald guy in you, too.
I love Robotech!
Of course you do. You're a nerd. For the rest of you, Robotech was an animated show from the 80s. If you thought Inspector Gadget was too gritty, then Robotech was for you. I won't bore you with the storyline here. Two fans already know what's up. Just know this. Earth has been invaded by an alien race. You gotta help kill them all.
Hey, how about that gameplay?
What about gameplay? Well, Robotech Invasion is a simple basic shooter and doesn't seem to strive for much more.
I love inferiority.
Well, then you'll be happy to know that the action is so-so. The weapons you've seen a gazillion times and the missions are as average as a CBS sitcom.
Hey, my finger.
Even the addition of the Cyclone, a suit of armor slash motorcycle, isn't enough to bring the excitement level above ho-hum. Biker boys do not make their own rules here. Get your Cyclone running. Head out on the highway, looking for some aliens, and whatever comes your way. Here's an exact spot where Robotech jumps the shark, or canyon, as it were.
Wow! This game sounds completely below average! Tell me more!
Well, Lolli, I could tell you about the plain Jane visuals of the game, but I won't. I could mention the tedious soundtrack. I won't. I should bring out the unremarkable voice acting, but what would be the point?
You gotta stop sniffing that glue, my friend. It's starting to mess with your mind. El Loco, you know what I'm saying?
But it's not all bad. The best thing in Robotech Invasion has to be the death gurgle. Robotech Invasion is less than ordinary in every way. If you love Robotech, I'm sure you're already salivating at the prospect of owning this game.
Most of my friends ignore me, too.
But if you don't know Robotech from indie rocker Beck, then you'll ignore this game like the Jimmy Fallon movie. Robotech Invasion gets a below average 2 out of 5.
So what do we do now?
Grab a sponge. It's time for Adam's pedicure.
Oh, Adam, the show is not Spartacus, and the interns are not Tony Curtis. Don't tell me you made them give you a pedicure.
Of course not. Made them give me a sponge bath. Snails and oysters for everyone.
Coming up, we know you didn't want another Vietnam game, but we got you one anyway.
Oh boy, the holidays are busy. I can never get everything done. But my brother Chris, he was born ready. Heck, he was walking at 3 months. Me? I prefer the thrill of last-minute shopping.
Hi, I need some stuff quick.
Sure.
For my wife, my uncle, 3 cousins, and some elves.
All right.
There's only one Kris Kringle. For the rest of us, there's Best Buy.
Fighter, Mage, Thief. Experience the powers of the original Final Fantasy with all new storylines and game elements. Final Fantasy 1 and 2, Dawn of Souls. Only for Game Boy Advance. Rated E for everyone.
Hi. I was wondering if you would recommend an internet service provider.
No ISP, huh? Here. Check this out.
Netscape?
Netscape Internet Service. You can get unlimited internet access for only $9.95 a month.
$9.95?
Plus, you can customize your service with all these other great features like Web Accelerator, Email Virus Scan, and Advanced Spam Block for just a few dollars more per month. With Netscape, you only pay for what you need.
For unlimited internet access and email, get the Netscape internet service for only $9.95 a month. It's fast, safer, reliable, and your satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. Try the Netscape internet service risk-free for 30 days. And with Web Accelerator, you can surf the web up to 5 times faster. Call 1-888-268-0350 or go online to getnetscape.com.
Millions have experienced the legend. Now it is time for you to join the quest. Behold the future of online gaming. EverQuest 2, where adventure comes alive. Rated T for teen.
Sir Kill-A-Lot, Mr. Psycho, Fluffy, the world's greatest metallic murder machines in an all-or-nothing battle to the death. Get that toaster out of here. This rig is for robots. Robot Wars, new episode tonight at 10.
Watch the entire series of Last Exile in December!
Ah! Catch the anime series Last Exile starting tonight at midnight, only on Anime Unleashed.
Think of them as the parents I never had. It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Yes, the negligent, indifferent parents he never had.
So sweet. Welcome back to X-Play. Now, later in the show, we have our review of the biggest PC game of the year, Half-Life 2.
And we waited 6 years for it, so you can wait 10 more minutes.
Why? Because first, we have another Vietnam game. Okay, in the last month, something like 6 Vietnam games have been released, which raises one important question.
Why? I mean, yeah, there are dozens upon dozens of World War II games. At least some of them shake things up by having zombie Nazis, like in Return to Castle Wolfenstein.
Or vampire Nazis, like the original Blood Rain.
So far, there are no Viet Cong zombie games. But if developers keep cranking out titles like Conflict Vietnam, it's only a matter of time before the North Vietnamese unleash their undead upon unsuspecting GIs.
But until then, we'll just have to fight an enemy who hasn't been reanimated. Here's our view of Conflict Vietnam.
My great-grandfather went to war. My grandfather went to war. My father went to war. I wasn't like them. I never went to war. I went to Vietnam. Damn that war. But it's all good, because I can recapture my nightmares all over again with Conflict Vietnam for the Xbox. Uh-oh, I'm having another flashback. It seems like Vietnam, my war, has become somewhat trendy in the gaming world. The more Vietnam games, the better, I say. I'm sick of those WW2 bastards getting all the glory. They don't know. They never went to Nam. I've played Conflict Vietnam. I know. Somebody once wrote, hell is the impossibility of gaming. That's what Conflict Vietnam feels like, hell. A torturous gaming journey through hell. If I'm going to be knee-deep in the fertilizer, I'd prefer not to waste it walking around picking up army gear. If I wanted to pick up medical supplies, I'd call Andy Dick. That's what my Nam was about. It's time for another flashback. At least the game got the scenery right. That's what I'll always remember. The look and feel of Vietnam. One day, I vowed to return. Build a mini mall, perhaps a juice bar, nail salon type thing. Who can say? One can never say. In the Nam. Sadly for me, the firefights remind me of then. It's all a blur. I don't know what's right or wrong anymore. Did somebody say flashback? That was weird, but so was the Nam.
Charlie.
We called them Charlie because we were fans of Charles in Charge. Damn that, Scott Baio. There they are, the AI. Most of them got nothing. They're poor, they're the unwanted. Maybe that's why they call themselves Bad AI. Because Bad AI can take anything. You smell that? Do you smell that? That's unmanageable control, son. Nothing else in the world smells like that. And the gun sights. Look at those gun sights. I love the smell of mediocrity in the morning. Here they come to snuff the rooster. Aw, yeah. So how do I really feel about conflict in Vietnam? I watched a snail crawl along the edge of a straight razor. That's my dream. That's my nightmare. That's conflict in Vietnam. A slow, ponderous road for your Xbox. I give it 2 inner demons out of 5.
Adam, you sound like a Wookiee when you die.
If you must play a Vietnam game this year, please choose Battlefield Vietnam, because both of the other games are more protracted and painful than the actual Vietnam conflict.
Or you could just play one of the Cloud City battles from Star Wars Battlefront, which has actual Wookiees, and Empire Strikes Back is like a dark Vietnam-esque chapter of the Star Wars franchise.
Which would make Episode 4 like World War II, and Alderaan is the new Poland.
I know. I just realized something.
What?
We are dorks.
Oh, yeah.
Coming up. It's a bad day to be a good guy. An evil genius.
Hey, what do you got?
Desktop to Miami.
You know my grandma lives in Boca? Say hi to her for me.
Okay.
This season, take delivery of a Gateway PC with a fast Intel Pentium 4 processor, only $499.99. Or go mobile with one of our notebooks, just $699.99 and found only in a Gateway box.
I wanted to get everyone cool gifts and not pay too much. Now it's too late. I blew it.
Actually, you didn't blow it.
I didn't?
No, you didn't.
Still looking for the perfect gift? It's easy to wrap up the whole store today with a Circuit City gift card. And save $50 on this Fujifilm 3.2 megapixel digital camera with 6x optical zoom, just $149.99. Circuit City.
Hi, I'm Karen from Infrastructure DB, and here's Winterfuel on the Winterfresh Network. Oh, yes!
Unhand my Winterfresh gong.
The Winterfresh gong is rightfully mine.
Ha 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 ha! Oh yes! Oh yes!
Winterfresh Network, where icy cool breath is always on.
Those who fought for freedom, it was their finest hour. Call of Duty, finest hour, rated T for teen.
The worst part was the pressure. Phone calls at home, phone calls at work, letters in the mail.
It was nice to help. Since Debt Free works with thousands of creditors, we got his interest lowered and his penalties eliminated.
Every day, thousands of people call Debt Free, a nonprofit organization.
I was snapping at everyone, on edge all the time. I just didn't know how to deal with it.
I think it was the first good news she'd heard in a long time. I explained everything Debt Free could do to help her, and we figured out she could pay off her debts in 5 years and still have money left over every month.
I wanted to do something. I just didn't know where to start.
I showed her she could make just one monthly payment, and she didn't need to borrow money to do it.
Stop running from debt. Call Debt Free today.
I'm back to my old self. I'm glad I called Debt Free.
I'm not snapping at people anymore.
If you're overwhelmed by debt, gather your bills and call Debt Free now.
I'm getting out of debt and I'm doing it myself. And I'm pretty proud of that.
Sir, G4 Tech TV is airing all 26 episodes of Last Exile on Christmas Day.
Put on a pot of coffee and bring me some adult diapers.
What?
The Last Exile Marathon, Christmas Day, starting at noon Eastern.
Anybody want to make out with a disembodied guy? It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
No, thank you.
Hopefully, someone will make out with this embodied guy first.
No, thank you. God. Welcome back to X-Play.
Later, we have our Half-Life 2 review. But first, a PC game where you get to play a supervillain.
No, it's not City of Heroes spin-off City of Villains. It's a strategy game called Evil Genius. And here's our review.
Right, listen up, team.
There have been reports of a new player in the underground. We don't know who it is, but we know they're organized, motivated, and building a team of henchmen and minions, the like of which the world has never seen before. This person is attempting to become an evil genius.
Throw The Sims, Risk, and Dungeon Keeper into a shark tank, and the resulting chum water would taste like Evil Genius, a strategy title that brings together all the best vices like Bogart and Bacall and a double date with Turner and Hooch.
Greetings, oh evil one.
So, is taking over the world difficult? Nah. Just increase your notoriety without catching too much heat for your nefarious acts of infamy. Your minions build your secret lair while frightened tourists get interrogated because they freak out around body bags that have corpses of agents who fell into a dastardly trap created by an evil genius who extends a circle of influence to boost morale so your lackeys will schlep dynamite, eat a hot meal, play ping pong, and enjoy a refreshing soft drink. Sound hard? Don't worry, it is. If you're new to strategy games, this one will mock you like Ashley Simpson on SNL. You actually have to program how your traps kill intruders. What is this, Fortran? This screen is supposed to show how you're doing. Unless you study statistics at MIT, I say skip it. Building your secret lair is groovy, man. But after sending minions into the world to commit crimes, you'll sit around waiting for cash and notoriety to arrive. This gets old. Attention, attention, my evil minions! I am bored! That is all. So I did what any board gamer does. I got out my Game Boy. Yes, playing a game, well, playing a game is what I've been reduced to. Henchmen have all the evil traits you could want.
Right on!
They kill. They smoke. Plus, they smoke. Smoking's twice as bad as killing. And being a good American, unburdened with things like scruples, the bodies will pile up. Servants, foreigners, women. It's like Rock'em Sock'em Minorities. Trouncing infiltrators in the freezer rocks. Now I don't have to move the bodies.
Das ist gut, ja.
Sometimes all the beds will catch fire and explode. At first I didn't know why. Then I figured out. Beds just explode. That's a relief. Evil Genius is decent entertainment. The creative idea and the 60s-style kitsch are implemented well. If the pacing were picked up, it'd be downright diabolical. As it is, evil's not bad. A 3 out of 5.
Blender, I gotta remember that one. Now stick around. When we come back, 6 years of waiting are over.
Waiting for what?
Just watch.
Forking snit! It's our Half-Life 2 review!
Oh boy, the holidays are busy. I can never get everything done. But my brother Chris, he was born ready. Heck, he was walking at 3 months. Me? I prefer the thrill of last-minute shopping.
Hi, I need some stuff quick.
Sure.
For my wife, my uncle, 3 cousins, and some elves.
All right.
There's only one Kris Kringle. For the rest of us, there's Best Buy.
Break out the honors. X-Men Legends is one of the best co-op games of the year. Game Informer declares it's the X-Men game we've all been waiting for. X-Men Legends, rated teen.
Worms and germs can attack your computer.
Something's wrong with your computer, and you've tried everything.
Try this.
One quick click. Velos will keep your entire system virus-free, safe, and secure.
With Velos, to make it faster than the day you got it.
Visit Velos.com.
And make it quick.
If you even think you're slowing down, get a free virus scan at Velos.com and make it fast.
It will summon you. It will challenge you. It will consume you. Mortal Kombat Deception. Online for PlayStation 2 and Xbox. Rated mature.
The circle is complete. The trilogy has ended. And now the winner of 11 Academy Awards can be seen in a whole new light. Own The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King, the special extended DVD edition. Featuring over 50 minutes of new and extended scenes, supervised by director Peter Jackson. If you don't have it in your collection, you're missing out on the greatest DVD experience of all time. The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King. Own the special extended DVD edition today.
Once again, two people who have been waiting 6 years for this, Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to X-Play.
For the last half a decade, we have been looking forward to the release of Half-Life 2.
Now, this year, the PS2 had Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
The Xbox had Halo 2.
And the GameCube, well, it was supposed to have Resident Evil 4.
But now, it's time for the PC people to prepare themselves for some serious shock and awe when we at last bring you our review of Half-Life 2.
Rise and shine, Mr. Freeman.
Yes, Gordon Freeman, you've overslept long enough. Half-Life 2 has been so long in coming, even the characters in the game seem surprised to see Gordon.
Gordon Freeman?
Gordon Freeman!
Gordon Freeman? Is that you?
Dr. Gordon Freeman himself.
Gordon Freeman.
That's not who I think it is.
Gordon Freeman? It's incredible you made it.
Okay, enough. Gordon's been gone a while and is suddenly plopped down in City 17. Jackbooted alien thugs in gas masks called the Combine are in charge now, but Gordon's old friends from Half-Life 1 aren't about to let that go unchallenged.
It's me, Gordon. Barney from Black Mesa.
Nothing like reuniting with old friends in long-awaited sequels.
I'm way behind on my beating quota.
Too much info. After some exposition and the requisite failed teleportation experiment, Half-Life 2 kicks into gear and never stops moving.
Gordon Freeman.
The graphical improvements are immediately evident. This is one of the best-looking games made yet, and the character animation and facial expressions are second to none.
Dr. Freeman, I presume.
The gameplay is familiar on a base level. You point, you shoot, you occasionally solve rudimentary puzzles.
Good job, Gordon. Throwing that switch and all. I can see your MIT education really pays for itself.
But the element of Half-Life 2 that really changes everything is the Havoc physics engine. Just about everything in the game has its own mass, weight, and can be affected by Gordon. This TV stuff will rot your brain. So will the TV stand. The physics are so integral to the game that you're even given a gravity gun to play with them.
You can call it the zero-point energy field manipulator if you really want to.
I really don't.
That's the old passage to Ravenholm. We don't go there anymore.
Can't imagine why. Who doesn't love headcrab zombies? Yeah, you better shamble away. The creepy zombie-infested town is not only scarier than anything Doom 3 throws at you, it may be the best place to play around with the gravity gun. You can pick up nearly anything and fire it off as a projectile. For instance, cardboard? Not the best anti-zombie weapon. Washing machines? Much more effective. Or you can use the various traps scattered about. Ha! Eat this! Uh-oh, time to improvise. If you didn't think that was cool, you're in the wrong hobby. One of the constant downfalls of first-person shooters is that eventually, shooting things in the head gets old. Half-Life 2 nimbly dodges this pitfall by changing things up regularly. There are vehicle sections that, unlike just about every other driving sequence in the genre, are tons of fun to play. Note to Combine Forces, your roadblocks suck. Later in the game, you get your own army of Starship Troopers rejects to swarm the Combine. By the end, it's full-scale war in the streets against monstrous striders. Very few games ever reach the breakneck pace and intensity level that Half-Life 2 maintains throughout. It's packed with cool moments and memorable characters.
Look to your own salvation.
This is the closest thing to a flawless game we've played in a very long time. X-Play gives Half-Life 2 a 5. Out of 5.
All right, there you go.
Okay, now leave and go play the game.
Play Half-Life 2. What are you doing? You should be playing it. Don't look at me. I'm not allowed to look that good.
I hate Adam Sessler.
I'd rather suck on a urinal puck than play this game.
Why does he get to play video games and review video games on our show about video games? Why does he get to spend every day with Morgan Webb?
We've got a preview of the hottest new releases.
Yeah!
Obsessed with video games? Watch X-Play with Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb. Weeknights at 11.